Hi, I'm Rajat Chaturvedi. I did my graduation in civil engineering and I have a work experience of 1 year in the construction industry after that. I am currently studying in Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies in finance. Hi, what I believe is that we should bring about a positive change in the lives of people, and for that I thought that acquiring management skills along with technical skills was important. So to bring about that change in the society, I thought that if I get the relevant skills, I'll able to do that. While I was studying in the final year of graduation, I gave my first CET attempt. I achieved a score of 97 percentile. Then I started researching about colleges. I came across JB. I got to know about its legacy of 53 years and the top-notch management graduates that have passed out from there. So I decided that I had an offer from a construction, Mumbai-based construction firm. And so I decided that I'll work for 1 year, study hard, and get a good score to get into JBIMS. First of all, what I would like to suggest to you all is your performance in any other exam is not going to any way affect your performance in CET. So whatever exams you have given before, your CET performance will be independent of that. Also, what I did was, TIME has this comprehensive test series. Starting from the diagnostic test, if I look at my performance from the first test that I gave to the last mock test that I gave, I saw a huge difference in how I was scoring marks. So how these mock tests, they help you is, you get to know what your strong areas are, what your weak areas are, and at the same time, you also get to know what your priorities are. So if I used to believe that, if I take an example, I was really good at solving those round table puzzles and arrangement questions. But what used to happen was when there were a lot of constraints and variables in those questions, I used to end up wasting 10 to 12 minutes for 6 answers. So then I knew that these are my strong areas, but that is not my priority for the exam. I had decided that I'll not pile up all the AIMCETs towards the end. So what I did was, irrespective of my preparation, I used to give the mock test which was supposed to be given at centers to get a feel of how the actual test day environment would be like. So irrespective of my performance, I made sure that even if I score good, I'll go to the test center and I give that mock test. And there is a separate set of mock tests which you can give from home. So those are the ones which I gave towards the end. Also, after giving a lot of mocks, I realized that I was stuck at a certain score and I wasn't improving myself. So during the last 15 days, what I did was I changed my strategy. My initial strategy was I used to start with abstract reasoning, then go with English, then go with analytical reasoning, and in the end, I used to solve quant. So I realized that for quant, there is very little time left for me. So I changed the strategy and I started with abstract, went with English, then did quant first, and then in the end, I solved analytical reasoning. So even though I enjoyed analytical reasoning the most, but I thought that I'll do it towards the end because it is time consuming and I'll not get attached to any of the sections was what my strategy during the actual exam. So I also made sure that I did not spend more than 1 minute over any question because the time was very limited and getting attached to these questions was not something that I really wanted to do, which I did in mock test, and I realized that I wasted a lot of time for that. In CET, as you all know, there is no negative marking and you have to make sure that you attempt all the questions towards the end, irrespective of if you know it or you don't know it, but in the end, keep some time for random marking because you have to make sure that you attempt all the questions. The key to achieving a good score in CET is solving a lot of mock tests, according to me. At the same time, I would also like to add one last point, that don't run behind any cutoffs because the cutoffs are really relative and depend on the difficulty level of the paper. So what I want you all to do is make sure that you solve maximum questions on your own and try to get the maximum right answers. Don't run behind any numbers. I wish you all the very best for your CET.